Hey, what's up, people? So good to see you all here. This is Christian, and I am showing you today how you can build an epic WordPress website in 1 hour. So before I start, I would like to introduce myself. As I said, my name is Christian, and I've worked at Google for 1 year and then decided this is nothing, this is not for me. I gotta, have my own plan, my own be my own boss basically, and started traveling the world, being a digital nomad, doing web design. And I've always liked WordPress. I taught myself in college how to work with it. Back then it was a little like clunky, but now there's so many like good solutions out there to easily build a website like very fast, very pretty, very quick. So that's what I'm gonna show you today. All you're gonna need for that is the WordPress theme files that I've provided for you in this video. Just click the download button that is in Crowdcast, which is the video platform I'm recording this, and or click the link in the chat because I've uploaded it on my Google Drive just in case the button doesn't work or anything like that. So before we start, I would like to point out that this is a donation-based class. And I usually charge $900 to $1,500 for the website I build for clients. So you're getting a tremendous amount of value. And feel free to donate if you haven't. You don't have to. I'm just asking you if you feel you've gotten some value out of this class to donate now or at the end of the class. And I'm gonna prompt the little donate button right now if you feel you want to do so. And or you can do so at the end. And so the basic things you need for websites are basically like three things. So you need a domain name, which I think everybody knows what that is. It's the URL, name that appears in the browsing bar, and then you type in da 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 dot com dot net dot org dot whatever. And so that you need to, register with a domain registrant and preferably a hoster. And so the second thing is hosting. You need hosting. The hosting you need to have content behind that URL bar, basically. Very simplified explained. And so I personally, there's many of hosts out there. If you don't do anything crazy like a super big blog or an e-commerce site, or let's say like you're doing a membership platform, I would recommend a very simple cheap platform like HostGator. And I do actually have a coupon code for you for 25% off the all plans. If you feel guided to get your domain with them. I recommend them. They're cheap. They're good. I personally don't like GoDaddy. I don't like Bluehost because Bluehost, it's kind of, if you buy the shared hosting plan, I really don't like it. And it's kind of slow. I mean, it's similar to HostGator, but not as good in my opinion, when from what comes from my experience of working with hosting platforms. GoDaddy, I don't like for only one reason, because they charge extra, I think like $6 or $7 for an email address. So later on, if you want to have like info at yogastudio.com, you have to pay $5 a month, which is like ridiculous for an email. Like I have like 20 email addresses with all my domains combined, and I pay nothing for those email addresses because that's included in my hosting plan. I just think that's ridiculous, and that's a way to make money. So I don't like GoDaddy so much anymore. I've moved some clients away from there, and I'm using HostGator. So all you need to do is to choose a web address. For example, you got yogastudio.com, and then you click on search. Is that available? And then it will probably show you, the domains that are available. I would assume yogastudio.com is not available. But let's see, let's check that out. What does HostGator say? Sorry for the connection is a little slow because I'm like uploading video and sharing my screen at the same time. So it says, sorry, yogastudio.com is unavailable. So, you know, you choose a domain that is unavailable and then you continue to checkout. At checkout is usually, it's going to ask you about, it's going to ask you about, like if you want privacy protection, all that kind of stuff. In my opinion, you don't need that. It's just additional money that you pay. So type in your domain, your domain that you want to have here, and then, you know, go to checkout. And then for hosting plans, that one is usually, as I said, around $3 to $5 a month, which makes it about, you know, let's say $5 on average a month, which is about $60 a year. And then there's another domain that you need to buy, which is $12 a year. So that's $70 for having a website hosted on a hosting platform. So it's really not that expensive at all. And for WordPress, you don't pay anything. So the three steps to a website are, you know, you buy a domain, you buy hosting, and then you install WordPress on that hosting. So I, for example, already have a domain and an account with HostGator, so I'm going to log in here. It's going to say portal login, and it will bring up my email address because I've already logged in before. I click next and log in. I've added this little red circle around my mouse so you know where I'm going and what I'm clicking while my face is not on the screen and you see what I'm sharing here. So as you can see, this there's several packages in this account, and I'm going to go to hosting. Let's see what that brings up. This will show me all, you know, the websites, the domains that I have, the URLs that I have. Here I have the fullthebook.com. It says one installation available. So I have one more sort of blog or site available to install WordPress on, which I'm going to do. And in my case, I have a domain free that's called kylenordwall.com. It's a friend of mine, and I'm hosting him on the platform. And he is actually a yoga teacher, which we're going to decide kylenordwall.com. And the blog title is Kyle Nordwall. Just make it simple. So add blog. And usually it looks similar with other like hosting platforms. They have a way to just set up this WordPress install on your URL. So it's very simple. It's a one-click install, and you basically have your site up and running, at least, you know, WordPress installed. So when we sit here, we say that, you know, it's the installation is pending. So we wait a little while for that and see how fast that will be over. And in the meantime, I'm just going to, you know, tell you to download the theme files because we're going to install them, which you can see on the turquoise button on here, to download those because we're going to need them since we're going to build with them. So let me refresh, see where we are right now. I'm going to post the coupon code if you're interested for HostGator. Is the following. So that gives you, I'll post in a chat here in Crowdcast. It's Lovepixel 25. Lovepixel is my agency name that I build website with. And this one gives you 25% off all new hosting plans. And so you can just get one if you feel guided to. And I just wanted to, you know, disclose at this point that I do earn a commission of that coupon code. So just that, you know, you're supporting the family. You're supporting my growing family. I have a little boy. He's 4 months old right now at this time recording this. And yeah, kids are a journey. What a fun time. So let's see how Kyle Nordwall is doing. The installation is still pending. Not sure why it takes so long. It's usually faster, but just for the gist of it, we can see how that is doing. So let's see. session. Let's see, kylenordwall.com. Let's see, this is, if you type in slash WP admin, which WP stands for WordPress admin, then you might be able, depending if the, you know, database of WordPress is already installed. In this case, it says error, page cannot be displayed. So we're waiting until that is installed. There you go. Now it says WordPress is installed on kylenordwall.com. There you go. WordPress is installed. Perfect. We're happy. And we're going to click on that domain on the little settings gear over here. And it says manage WordPress, which is what we don't want to do. Email accounts, you can have email accounts with HostGator, so that's super easy. And you can also delete the WordPress install if you want to, you know, use it for a different domain. But what we're going to do is manage WordPress and go into that one, which is going to redirect us to the kylenordwall page, and where we're able to set that up. So here it says kylenordwall.com, and a dummy site from HostGator. So let me just try and log into his WordPress website, kylenordwall.com. Okay. I'm not sure why that is showing up. Okay, maybe that domain is just parked. So let me try, let me show you basically the steps with a different domain, and let's use this one instead. So you would click on manage WordPress in this window here. Then it will pop up, open, and redirect you to a different site. And it will walk you through an onboarding process where you can set your username, email address, and password, as well as the title of the page. So, you know, we're going to log in. We're in step 4 right now of our 22 steps. We're going to log into WordPress. And the first thing we want to do is to look up our username that we've created before on this site. In my case, I will use Kyle's kylenordwall.com, and that will give me here WordPress login for the full book is admin. This is our password. So just so we're, you know, logged in here. So instead of kylenordwall.com, we're going to use thefoolthebook.com. And same thing, just different domain. So what you want to do first thing is when you come back here in the back end, you want to change the password. So you're going to go to users, your profile, just to make sure your password is secure enough. And then you can scroll down here. On the very bottom, it's going to say to change your password. Here, generate password, and then update your profile. The next thing you want to do is go to settings and go to permalinks, because this one will change the what's appearing behind your, you know, your domain. So thefoolthebook.com/sample/something. So it doesn't include the date if you create a page or something like that. So just change that to post name, click save changes, and we updated our permalinks, and that one looks good. Perfect, permalink structure updated. And the next step is we are going to upload our themes. So you go to appearance, themes. There you go. I already have Divi installed, but you would just go to upload here and on the top, click upload. Take your theme file, which is divi.zip, and click upload theme up here again. You see, you have a bunch of other themes available if you want to, but Divi is really very flexible and super, super easy to use. So choose file and then scroll down to Divi, upload that, and it will ask you to activate the theme, and then it will look like this. So you have it installed. The next thing you need for the Visual Builder experience is the plugins. So you go to, you know, go down here to plugins, add a new plugin, which is going to be the Divi Builder. Let me check in with you guys if you have any questions. No, okay. Okay, so you hear the add plugin screen. So you upload your plugin. Again, same process. Choose the file. Choose the Divi Builder. And then it's going to ask you after you uploaded it to activate it. So activate that plugin and you will come out at this screen, which shows all your plugins that you have. And it will show you that the Divi Builder is installed. And depending if you activated it or not, it's activated or deactivated. So once we have this activated, we're ready to create our page. So let's go to Pages. Let's go to Add New. And we are going to build a yoga page. So let's say Kyle is a yoga teacher. So I'm going to call this page yoga. Okay. And we'll see here, which is... which, you know, only you have because you have the. So we're going to click on that one. Perfect. And once you're here, you get to the following, which looks a little bit complicated, but I will explain that to you in a very simple way. So the let's switch to the Visual Builder. Click here, Visual Builder. And that will load up a front-end editor, which is an editor you can, you know, edit visually with very easily. And that way you don't have, you know, a bunch of weird boxes hanging around and you don't know what everything's mean and what anything's related to. So in this case, you just get more of an idea, like what are we actually editing? Is it the text that we edit? Is it the image that we edit? So this front-end editor makes it very, very easy to navigate and to create a cool layout very quickly. So since Kyle is a yoga teacher, okay, see they even have like a little onboarding. If you're unsure how to do it, choose a pre-made layout. That works only if you have the bot version though. With the theme files I sent you, they're not there are the full versions, but you can't choose the pre-made layouts. You have to buy the theme for that. And it's really worth it. It's the best, you know, in my opinion, the best theme builder out there. I built all my websites with that. And it's just amazing. And so build from scratch. In this case, we're going to start building from scratch instead of choosing from layouts. Let's browse the layouts just so you get an overview of what is available there. So you could choose between, for example, let's say I think they have one in there that's a restaurant, an agency, a learning management system. They have fashion. Now, I have all kinds of different categories like lifestyle, food and drink, fashion, beauty, technology. They have one for a yoga studio, which we can look at. For example, it would look like this. Well, this is already pre-made layout that's easy to use, which you could say use this layout, and then it would import it. But we're not going to do that in this case. We're going to build one from scratch. So, just to explain you very easily, so we have this blue box that you see here all around the screen, and we have. Within that blue box, it's just loading again. There you go. So it loaded that section. It loaded the whole yoga studio. Okay. It's So that's one way. That's one way to go. You could just, you know, do that. You know, buy the premium version and switch out the whole yoga studio and just switch out the images and the text. That's a super simple way to do that. But I do not want to do that in this case. I want to just build from scratch because I want to show you how to use a builder and how to build your website that is just the way you want it and not the way the layout is. Even though you can always, you know, edit the layout the way that you want it, which is also super easy. So back again to that page because I didn't want it to take that layout. So let me just load that page for you. And let's get that up and running. So again, here we are with the Divi builder. And as I said to you before, it has a certain structure with the Divi builder that I'm going to explain to you. And we just get into the visual builder again, so that's easy to explain. So you see that it has the entire layout here, text, button, image, and you have the blue box and the green box. So basically when you're back here, the same is reflected in the visual builder. So the blue box is the section in which you have a row. A row is the green thing that is just a row within that section. You can have several rows. Here it says add rows. You can have several rows with different column layouts in one section. You can also have, you know, multiple sections with the same layout or different layout, whatever you feel is like your layout or whatever it is you want to create. So in my case, I'm going to clear the entire layout of this Yoga Studio page that was loaded. Clear layout, yes. And again, we're going to start from scratch. So we use the visual builder. It's going to load up in the front end, and you see what are you going to actually edit. So in our case, I prepared some files here, and we want to start with just creating the layout of our page. And I'm going to start with the top. The top is, for me, shall be a two-column layout. So I choose two columns here. There you go. And then it's loading a little slow here because I'm sharing my screen. I'm having so many things running at the same time. But basically, within the blue box, you see here the blue box, there's the green box. And within the green box, there's these gray plus buttons. The gray plus buttons, you can add elements. And these elements range from, you know, audio files, you know, buttons, you can add comments, contact forms, email opt-ins, map, you can add, you know, a portfolio or testimonial or some text. In my case, I'm just choosing text, and we're going to write something in there that is attracting to us, and we're going to write welcome to my yoga page. And as you see, I'm using these H1 tags. H1 stands for header one, that's HTML, which it's good to have like one H1 on each page, but only one because the search engine ranks and just like evaluates these words higher. Nothing particular you have to be concerned with too much, but if you value that, you can do that. This is also, you know, you can also go in here and let's say, okay, welcome to my yoga page. Great. But I wanted to edit this text so I can click into the text and actually make this bold, for example. Click up here, make it bold. Or I can see a text settings. I can choose a different header or font sizes. So there's 1,000 different options of the way you want it to look. And I'm just going to stick with the standard layout page layout for now. And we're going to add an image now to the background of my section. So the blue one you go to here, and whenever you click on these like gear icons, you get this little pop-up box, and it says it's the section settings or the row settings. You know, these all have different elements to edit with. So you have content, which you can add the background in there. You have the design, which manages the spacing above and below, and the layout, many things to play around with. Let's just add the background image for now. You see what that does. So here you have color, here we have gradient, here we have image, and we can even add a background video to that if we wanted to. So we're going to choose a background image, and I'm just going to upload a bunch of them, which I've already prepared, so that it's easier for us. Okay. So let's choose this one. This is Kyle. And then we see the following. Okay, this is a nice background, but it's somehow a little, it's not high enough. So I go to design, and I can either adjust the spacing in here, you know, custom padding. If you add, for example, 100, that's 100 pixel from the top, it will go down. But in this case, I won't do that. Just click OK because, you know, it can get a little bit technical. What you can do is you can just, like, you see how it shows the little blue bar here? You can just drag that down to increase the padding to make that image come down. You can also do the same from the top if you feel inspired to do so. But I'm happy with that. And one thing I really don't like is the color of the text because it's dark. I can't really read it at all. So I'm just going to go here to click on, see how it says, doesn't say section settings, says text settings. So everything has the same structure. You can add here in the content, the text. Also, maybe you want to give the text a background. But I just want to change the text color. So I go to text, text, and I open that up. That tab is going to open up, shows me all these different varieties of what I want to do. Let me have this to be bold and all in caps, things like that. And then here I can choose text color, and you can choose white there. You can generally define the color of the text if it's too light or dark. In this case, I'm just going to choose light. Boom. Perfect. I love that. I think it's a little... It's not big enough. So what I want to do is I want to go in here, and since this is the H1 element, I need to go into the heading text, H1 here, and define that as H1. I'm just going to increase the text size. Welcome to my yoga page. Love it. That's great. We're going to keep that. Click the check mark. And we're gonna here down there, you have a menu to save all the changes you made. So you hit publish or save. It's gonna say save later on because once you've published, you can only say save. So I've published that page so far. I have a beautiful header image and I have the text, welcome to my yoga page. And we can actually add a button here. So click the gray element. If I hover above, you know, any gray element, that's going to be the gray plus button. And I'm going to add an actual button. So that button, you know, looks like this. I like the style of it. It's very decent, very subtle. And then you can write here my mission. So once they click that, you can forward them to your mission. You can create a separate page for that or a section of the page. And I'm going to show you later how to just create that separate section. So I want to go down here and add a further section. Let me see. It doesn't quite seem to get there. So sometimes you need to just move that up a little bit so it doesn't, you know, interfere with your scrolling. And then I can click the blue button. I create another section. Within the section, again, we have rows. And within the rows, we have individual elements like text, buttons, blah, 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 email signups, etc. So you click regular. Let's say now, for example, I want to keep the second, the two-column layout. I click that one again. So I have you know, two columns within that section, within that row. And I'm going to write here on the left side, I want to text again. So in this case, I'm going to use Visual Editor. You can use that too instead of the text. There's two versions. In the text, you can write your HTML and things, tags like that, which you probably won't use. But I can write here my mission. So once you write that, you know, you can choose, oh, is this heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, heading 4. Let's go with heading 3. I don't want to have it too big. So let's click that OK. And then I'm going to write my mission. And I've written that already out here. My mission. So I click again. I click in the text box. And I click below. My mission is to enchant the world with the healing arts of yoga, Reiki, and meditation. Okay, let's see. Let's see if my computer gets that. Healing arts of yoga, Reiki, and meditation. Perfect. Let's make a dot there. That sounds wonderful. I don't really think it's big enough, so let me go into the design tab over here. Let me adjust the text a little bit. Okay, text size. Let's see, I wanted to have 24. And then also the heading text, which is an H3 on this one. I made that one an H3. Don't have too many, you know, H's, like headers types on your website, because Google likes to have only a few, like your heading types, make them H3, so Google crawls that correctly, and you know that ranks higher. Okay, let's make that 34. I like that. And on here, over here, we're just gonna click duplicate model, because over here, I wanted to have something similar. So here, we're gonna write, I support you with. You can also click up here, I support you with. And then this one, we're gonna make a bulleted point list. This one, there you go. I support you with all things around meditation. All things around yoga. All things around Reiki. All things around your healing. So, it's a very spiritual person. I myself am very spiritual, because otherwise I probably wouldn't do this class. Another cool effect that I'm going to show you to add now. So, for example, let's say I don't like this, you know, white and brown contrast. Let me choose a background for this, and let me make the background color gray. So let's choose F7. So that will make it light gray and not white. So it's just, you know, I know one of those codes, but you can choose literally anything. If you click in here, you can choose anything that you like. You can go with red, maybe a little bit too much. Blue, but I'll stick with the decent, very subtle gray, which I use this hexacode because it's just easier to enter in for me. But you can, you know, feel free to use the color picker to choose a color you like. So one thing we're gonna add right now is a really cool feature that Divi added, and it's you go into the section settings. So go to your blue box, click on the gear icon, go to the design section, go to dividers. And in there, we'll show you dividers top bottom. Now, this might seem confusing, but basically, you just, you know, give me a second, you'll see what I mean. So on this blue section on top of here with this header, this image, I want to add something on the bottom. and I want to make it look like this. Now you see it's on top. I don't want that. Let me just say none. I want it on the bottom. Okay, let me add this on the bottom like this. Yeah, doesn't that look cool? Amazing. So now we have a really cool section that just cuts off the header image in a really dynamic, you know, diagonal way. And I really like that. It makes the page super stylish and looks amazing. So let me duplicate that section and continue with our little website. So for this one, I don't want anything over here. I just want to have an about section. So I say, hi, I am Kyle. Perfect. I don't want that in the bulleted style, so please get rid of that, sir. Thank you. That stuff, I'm going to write, hey, I'm Kyle. There you go. Okay, hello, I'm Kyle. Let me have no bullets for this. I like the bullets on this one, I don't need it. Hello, I'm Kyle. Hi, I'm Kyle. Make this bold. Perfect. I love it. And then we're going to add a little background image on there, because when everything is just gray or white, it looks a little boring. So we're going to go to the section settings again, and the content settings, you'll find background, add your background image. And we're going to add this. So just a very quick way to make a page look really, really cool, really decent. And then let's say if I wanted to keep that diagonal look over here to do the same thing on here, I can go to the section settings and go to design, dividers. I want it on the bottom and I want it to look like this. So as you can see, it doesn't really transition well with the image. So I can choose either a different color. Or what I also can do, instead of, so it doesn't have the hard cut where the straight image is, I can go to this section, say design, dividers. And then this one is on top because it's on top of the image. So I can do this and do this. So there you go. You have a double diagonal section, which looks really cool in my opinion. It's just with dividers, you can play a little bit. So that's up to you. Then I'm Kyle. We're going to add another button. And we're going to say more about me. More about me. And then here at the link, I'm going to put the URL that I'm on. You know, I'm on thefoolthebook.com, or, you know, could be yogastudio.com, whatever, like wherever, the site that you, the URL that you registered, and then /about. So later on, we're going to link our about page to this. We haven't created it yet, but we're going to create it in a little bit. You're going to create it after. So I have this. This looks good, perfect, wonderful. And now I wanted to offer something that is okay. I wanted to show the services that I offer. So I offer three services, or Kyle offers three services, and these are yoga, Reiki, and meditation. So I click here, I make a little image here, and upload my little icons see, this is a demo image. I go to my folder where I have my icons already pre-downloaded. And I'm going to show you where you find really cool icons. I found those at, on there too. So you're going to go to www.flaticon.com. And on there, you get a bunch of royalty-free icons that you can use. You just need to mention the person who created it on your, you know, index or imprint page. And you can search anything on here. They're going to have tons of really beautiful, modern designed icons. So that's really, really cool. For example, if I wanted something for meditation, it's going to show me it has 500 icons for meditation. So that's really, really cool. You can search for anything. I'm sure you're going to find something really cool for there. See all these different ones. And you can go here and then, you know, hover these. And you're actually going to be able to, you know, click here on these three dots. And you're actually going to be able to download them in a PNG. So you're going to be, PNG means it supports transparency in the background. So it's not like white, it looks weird on a website or something like that because of your background image. No, you can download a PNG with a transparent background right from there. And you can sometimes even edit like the color with these things. Only logged in users see, you can pick a color if you need it in white or something like that. So that's a really cool resource. I'm going to post that onto the chat right now so you guys can go there later or now. And here I've already downloaded them. This one is the meditation icon. I've uploaded them into my WordPress backend. So I'm going to click that, upload image, boom. And here it is. It's my icon for meditation. Now this is a little bit too big for me. So I'm going to go to sizing and do like half or even smaller. Let me do 30. 30 sounds good. Let's put that in the middle. Lovely. And underneath that, I want to have a little bit of text so I can explain to people what I'm all about or what I do in my meditation classes. So here goes my content. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, let me duplicate that and just drag the same module over there and duplicate that one more time just to speed this process up a little bit here. So I have my images and that's perfect. In the design, I can choose where I want to align it, to the left, to the right. It's always going to center in the mobile. So you can choose what you want to have here. So let me copy this twice so we have something that looks unified. So you can just literally drag and drop these elements, and you're gonna be very fast at building a website that looks really, really epic. Let me switch out those images so it looks like something. Okay, here's my yoga mat, perfect. And I offer also Reiki, perfect. Okay, let me go with this Reiki hand. It looks beautiful. I love it. Wonderful. See, here's what I offer. Now I'm missing kind of like the headline, like what do I offer, like to write a text there. So I choose a new row And with only one column, so no three columns or two columns, just one that goes with the full width. And right here, what I offer, I make this a, let me make this a heading 3, and let me center this, perfect. And I want this above the text. There you go, drag and drop it above there. Boom, what I offer, this is what I offer. So here we are, ready to go. We have 10 minutes left on this live broadcast. I feel I'm gonna do a little bit longer if you guys are up for it. I mean, I can finish right now and just show you guys how to create more pages. Let's do one more thing on this page though, and let's add an email subscribe. So let's get rid of this and Let's get rid of this. Okay, I have this. All I want to do is have that empty section here and click here. And I'm going to choose a full-on layout. And I'm going to insert an email opt-in because we always want to capture people's emails before they go. So let's make this a full-on banner. As you see here, I don't really like the color of the background, so let me take that out and let me add that actually. You see white, now the text is gone, but we're gonna add a text background to the section that's behind the actual email sign-up form. So let's make that turquoise. Let's see where we have turquoise. Not sure if I pronounce that correctly in German. Turquoise in Deutsch. Okay, I like that. This looks great. Now I can go in and customize this. Your title goes here, content goes here. Here you can have all kinds of settings with the email opt-in. So you can either see it says email fields. It says the fields. You can choose to have the last name or the first name. I just want the email, so that's fine with me. I think that looks really great. And if you go to email account, let's say MailChimp is my provider, then you can select a list, but you needed to add that account first. So you need to add your account name and your API key. And I'm just going to show you real quick where you can find that. So you log into MailChimp.com or whoever is your provider. MailChimp is just, you know, cheap, easy, quick, super easy to deal with. I love MailChimp. This is their website, and we're gonna log in here. Okay, we're gonna log in with our username and our password, which you can also create a new account. I already have one, so we'll just log into here. It's gonna ask you, you know, a bunch of questions when you sign up, like what's your address and things like that, because you need to have that when you're actually sending out mass emails or more emails. So I'm going to go to lists. There you go. It will show you all my lists that I have here. And then I click on Love Warriors, for example. And then I go to settings. Within that list, I go into settings. Okay, got it. Thank you, thank you. And I want to go to, oh no, scratch that. I'm going to go to account. Yeah. You don't want to go into list, you want to go into account. Sorry for that. So you click up on your image up here in your profile, and you go to account. And then you're going to click on extras, and you're going to see API keys here. There you go. Just get your API key, copy your account name, which in my case is Nitro12345, and then the API key. Perfect. Submit, and it's going to verify the information if I connected it correctly. And it says wonderful. It seems like it worked because it shows all my lists here, and I can put these people in all kinds of lists that I want to. And once I've chosen a list, let's do Love Warriors because I'm all about love. Okay, so once they click the subscribe button here, they're automatically added into the Love Warrior list, and I can send them an email out of MailChimp later. So this is a full-on website. The only thing that we're missing is how to modify the header bar, the menu bar here, and we don't have a footer. So this is what we're gonna take care of right now, if you feel you want to do that. So let's save that. Let's click on these three dots down here, and let's save our page. And then once that's saved, we're going to exit out of the Visual Builder and we're going to get to our actual page. So here we are. And this page is fully working. It's online. Perfect. Wonderful. I love it. Okay. So let's go to our dashboard. We technically have 5 minutes left, so I think we're going to go a little bit over. But so the footer you'll find in appearance and widgets. So let's say in footer area one, I just want to have a little bit of about text. So you're going to drag this text box down here. In here, in the footer area one, you're going to write about, and that's text. Perfect. I love it. And let me, footer area two, we're going to have some links. Links of my page, and then you can link list your links. Link two and link three. Perfect, I love that one. And in my footer area number three, I would love to have some social icons because social icons are important. Connect with me. Perfect, we're gonna leave that like this. Dismiss, save. And the social icons you can find very easily on fontawesome.com. Offer all kinds of free icons, and they're very modern, very cool. The cool thing about importing a font library like this into your website is that you don't have to deal with images. Like, I could upload images in here. In here, I could upload images, but maybe the mobile, they look shitty because they're not Retina ready, or, you know, like resolution is not right. So you want to use something like Font Awesome that scales responsively, and no matter what type of screen you have in front of you, iPad, iPhone, you know, high res, low res, it's always going to display correctly and look good, instead of using like the image of Facebook and just put a link behind the image and then go to Facebook, something like that. So here we go to Font Awesome. It's a really great site, so learn how to use, and we're going to go there. Basically, we're going to import a styling sheet, which is nothing like a piece of code, into our website that makes it possible to use these icons like Facebook, Instagram, YouTube as a font, as a type font. So you see this link here, link around this style sheet, blah, blah, blah. Just copy this one, go back to your site, and go down to Divi theme options. In your, so this is your... These are your options within your themes. You can, you know, do all kinds of stuff. You can change the logo back here. You can just like adjust the colors palette. You know, if you have any default colors you want to work with. Basically, nothing crazy that you have to worry about. It shows your show Facebook icon, show Twitter icon, show Google Arts, show all these icons. We just leave that enabled so you can take that out however you feel. But we're gonna go to integration. And integration, we want to, in the head of your blogger, we want to add this piece of code that we just copied. Make sure you add it into the head of your blog, which means that will load on all the pages. So hit save changes. And then, now that we have this font or this styling sheet imported, we're going to look for icons. So I want a Facebook icon because I love it. I have Facebook on my website, you know, people always love to look on Facebook and Instagram to check you out, to see if you're real. So let's go to the icons that are matching that. And I kind of like this icon with the square with the round corners here. That's really cute. And so I'm going to click on that. It's going to load up. And you see this code down here, iClass something something. This is the one you want to copy. And go back to your widgets, And let's say I want this in here. Okay, perfect. Just copy that code in here. Instagram. Take that one. Okay, wonderful. Okay, again, copy that code, put it back in here, and now we're gonna also look up YouTube. I'm cool. I have a YouTube channel. Perfect. Let's click on that one. Let's see how that does. And get the little code snippet for this one. Okay. Sounds awesome. Okay, so we have YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook. So let's hit you, make sure you post it in the text box, not in the visual, because the visual doesn't really doesn't interpret these brackets and everything as HTML. So copy it in the text box, hit save, and then let's look at our page. Let's do the full, thebook.com/yoga. So here's a page you've created before. Let me completely load that. Okay, and then you can go down and let's disable that. Okay. As you see, we have Facebook, Twitter, G+, and the feed here, which is not really what we want. So in that case, we go back to Divi, theme options, and it says back here on the first theme options page, to show the footer icons, see here on this first page, it says show Facebook icon, show Twitter icon, show Google icon, show RSS icon. We actually don't want to show these because we can't really add. You can add other like Instagram, Facebook, and like YouTube to it, but it's a little bit more complicated, which is why I showed you this easy version with the font awesome. So let me disable that for you and save changes. And then let's see what happens down there. Okay. So it still doesn't seem to show up. So let's see, maybe it has to do with that the footer is not correctly formatted. So maybe it doesn't show the footer bar the way I want it to be shown. So let's click into our theme customization tab and dashboard, which is the place where you can actually like adjust elements like globally. Let's say, for example, all the text that you wrote, you don't want to adjust it to like 18 pixel font size. You can do that like globally in the back end here. So as I said, you can do so by going when you're in your back end, your dashboard on the back end, you can go to theme customizer, and then this will load up. And as you can see, here's our page. This is how it looks. And I can change, here you go. Here's the about text, here's the links, and here are the icons. You can Google on the fontawesome.com page on how to make these icons bigger. It's very easy. And then also, for example, I want to show you that you can choose different header layouts. So header navigation, you can have a primary menu bar. The header format is, you can have header style that's centered. you know, and that way you get the fool's journey and the menu point centered. You can have the logo inline, which is in line with the menu points, inline. And you can also have a slide in that is just on the side there that slides in. So there's all kinds of different modifications that you can do and have fun with to edit your layout and your how it looks. So one thing that I'm going to show you is how to edit the navigation and set the homepage to home. So the homepage settings down here, you click on here, and it's going to show this first, but this we don't want to show our latest posts as the homepage. We want to have a static page. So a static page, let's say I want to have the yoga one as the homepage, and then that's going to display as the fullthebook.com, like URL, and this is going to be the front page. It's going to display the front page. So we don't have to type in slash yoga or slash, you know, slash something. But it's actually going to be the front page. So this is an important step to keep in mind. And one more thing I'm going to show you right now is to, you know, edit the content already. We've the blog post. I'm going to show you how to do that. So you're going to exit out of that. Okay. Leave. And here there's pages and there's posts. So posts are blog posts, and if you want to write a blog post, you can do so on this section. You see all the posts here. You can add a new post, and that one you can, you know, fill with images or put in different categories. You have different format available, video, audio, quotes. You can put tags in there if you want to do, you know, it's kind of certain categories or keywords. And you can also use the Divi Builder in your blog post to make them really look good. You know, because this is just a text box, which looks kind of odd. So you can use the Divi Builder for it, for cool blog posts. So you give yourself a title, and then you can publish that post. So that's a way to add blog posts, and those blog posts you can display on a page that you choose. You can choose. You can create a new page if you like. Page add new. Okay, create a little blog post page. You can have here a new page, which you can title blog. Perfect. And then use a Divi Builder. Because this is a page, and on that page we can stay in here for, because there's nothing fancy. We just choose a one column layout, insert a module, and as a module we choose blog. So this is on this page will appear the blog that we fill with our blog posts. So post number that are supposed to show, also the design. You can choose if you want to show the excerpt, things like that. You want the layout as a grid, just for this purpose. And then we can, you know, when we finish with our design setting, we can preview it, and you'll see all the blog posts, all the posts that we've written, which in this case is only one, the Hello World, and it doesn't have an image. Usually an image would appear under the title if you've uploaded one, but this is just a test one. And then you can click on the, you know, blog post in here, and it would, you know, show you a blog post, like if you write an entry about your journal or something like that. So that is, you know, now you have a blog, so that's wonderful. And then we are pretty much done. The only thing, you know, create your logo, upload your logo. The home, about, service, and contact pages, you can create yourself now. So just do the same thing as the homepage, you know, create a new page, call it about, and start creating. Either import a layout or start creating from scratch. It's very simple. Just put in your text, put in your images, adjust the spacing a little bit, and boom, you're done. One last thing I wanted to mention to you is FavIcon. The FavIcon is on top of the browser, this little crocodile hill, because that's our host. So they put that from by default in there. we want to change that, and you can do so in the Divi, and the Divi options, like settings on the page in the dashboard. And I think it's an integration. I am not sure because they moved it from the logo page. Let me just look through here real quick. Navigation. No builder. No layout. No ads. No SEO. Let me see. Okay, so I'm not really sure where to add the favicon. They moved that in this update somewhere. Oh, I know where it is. It's in theme customizer. Gotcha. It's not in the back end here. You have to go to the theme customizer, which is this dashboard here again that lets you define things globally. And then you go to general site settings. Let me wait till it loads up here. I'm a little slow today. I think it's a little bit too much for my laptop. Sharing the screen and talking and being streaming all that live at the same time. It's a little crazy for my little old MacBook. So once we're here, we want to go to general settings, as I said, to change our little crocodile, little favicon. You want to go to site identity and then site icons is this is where we're going to add the little favicon. And let's say, for example, I'm going to use the little hand. Select that, crop image. And there you go. You see up here the hand, how it changed. Now you have a custom favicon. You can also change the tagline here, the site title, the full, the book, and then tagline, or change that to Kyle Nordwall Yoga, healing the world with yoga. Hit publish, and you're done. As you can see up here, it won't say the full, and then just another WordPress website anymore, the tagline, but it will actually say whatever you entered there once you reload the page. And we're gonna just stay here for a while. I'm gonna show that the full the book, the full the book. Okay. See up here, it says Cal Nordwall Yoga and Healing. Perfect, that's what we just changed. So that's perfect. One thing I want to show you before we go is that you can change all header navigations. There's also one, the bar when you start scrolling is the fixed navigation setting. So when you can change the background color of this, let's say the red, and then this gets red. Just an example. One more thing is if you want to change the, you know, the text size, you go to general settings, typography, and then you can change all the body text size. So let's say, for example, I want all the body text to be different. I can do so here. Let me go to the yoga page to show that to you. Okay. I'm going to click the theme customizer, and in there you can adjust fonts and headings globally, so you don't have to adjust every single element, the font size and, you know, the styling and all that kind of stuff. So you can do that in there. Give me 1 second to load. Okay. So just to be respectful of your time, I'm going to do 10 more minutes of live streaming, and then you guys can ask me questions if you feel to. Just comment in the comments below. And so as I said, you can change the general settings and typography. you can change the size of the text. That's for example, I want to change the size of this text here, what I offer. So you go to body text size and you just increase those letters. Perfect, 16 sounds good. I want all the header text size to be bigger. So you define that globally. So you know, all the headers are getting, you know, bigger on the site. And you can change the link colors and everything, the default theme font and header font and body font. So all that kind of stuff you can do here. And it's a lot of fun. So have fun playing. And yeah, there's that's about it. That's about it. So if you have any questions about how to, you know, create a new page or edit the navigation, things like that, let me know. Okay. Okay, somebody wants to know the navigation. Okay, so let me go back and show you the where you can edit the navigation. So we X that off here, leave. Let's just not make these changes for now. So navigation, you'll find under appearance and menus. So under your menu, you won't see anything because yours is going to be empty. So I'm just going to create a new menu for this purpose. Once this is loaded, but you see your pages already on the left here, the pages that we've created. And so you don't have a menu again, so we'll create a menu. I'm going to change that to live stream. So this is just the name of the menu. It won't appear anywhere. It's just for my internal references. And then I can make this my primary menu. Make sure you check that so it shows on the front page. I can put my yoga page there. I can put my home and about page. Add to menu. We'll add that in that order. I can drag and drop it in the order I wanted to. Home, about, yoga. And then I can save that. And when I go to my front page, the book, this is my home page. In this case, I haven't made the yoga page the front page yet. So it's still this book that I've created, that book page. And so as you see, we have home, we have about, and we have yoga. And if you click on yoga, we automatically get to our yoga page that we've created in this tutorial. And here you go. The only thing we need to change maybe is the Fool's Journeys logo, which you can do in Divi and theme options. You can change that back here. Just upload an image that's white or has, you know, a shadow so you can see it in all the pages. You can upload that here. And that's about it. So if you, you know, if you like that class, I invite you to to donate. Stephanie's saying, hopefully we can watch a replay even a year from now. Yes, you can watch the replays many times. And you can also ask me for help if you ever need any assistance. I'm always here. This is my personal website. So I offer all kinds of, you know, digital services. And so, yeah, I'm always available. And I love to help out, especially people, you know, that are in my community. So if you have any questions on how to do something, then just let me know. Always here. So, yeah, again, if I know this is a little bit, might be a little bit too much for the first timers. But just, you know, play with it, rewatch the replays. That's how I taught myself, you know, how to design a website. It's just like, okay, go on YouTube, you know, find out how I do this, blah, blah, blah. You know, how to build a WordPress website in 1 hour or 3 hours or whatever it is. And then press play. Okay, press pause. Do the same thing. So if you guys are able to do that with that video, that, you know, is a huge honor. And I'm going to prompt the little donate button again in this Crowdcast platform because it's super fun for me. And yeah, you know, it was an honor to create with you. And if you have any questions, then let me know. If you get stuck up with you know, the theme or the hosting or the domain, all that kind of stuff can be confusing in the beginning. just leave something in the comments below and I'd love to help you out. Peace and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.